Counter-Strike that I brought out anti-video games activist and lawyer Jack Thompson to blame video games for violence in youth America. One of the games that he has attacked in the past has been Bully. Rockstar created this game Bully, and Thompson, before even playing or seeing the game, called it a Columbine simulator. When Bully was released in late October with a teen rating, the most formidable weapon was a slingshot, and the body count in the game was zero, which was lower than several G-rated Disney films. Dr. Phil also plays this role when he came out and blamed Counter-Strike for the Virginia Tech shootings before a suspect was even named. After further investigation, the shooter's pastimes were poetry and playwriting. Nothing showed that he even played video games during college. Being a gamer myself has made me wonder if playing video games will turn me into a violent killer. Haven't committed any crimes so far. How much of a link really is there between video games and real-life violence? How much of it relies on the shoulders of the parents? The Academy Gaming Center, located off the corner of College and Laurel, has been open since 2002. Tyson Parker, the owner, has been playing video games since the original Atari came out back in the 1980s. I asked him what he thought the relationship between video games and real-life violence was.
You know, it's one of those things where I think if you're predisposed to be a violent person, that you're going to be attracted to video games, and because it's another outlet for you. I don't necessarily think it's going to turn a normal person into this violent, rage-filled person who's going to run around committing acts of violence. That's just my personal opinion. You know, if you take a stable, normal person, you're not going to turn them into a mass murderer by playing video games.
So talking about parents, how much of a link do you think parents have in the way they bring up their kids to violence?
I think there's a dramatic link there. Parents are with you for most people 18 years of your life, and they're the most formative years of your life. They're passing on their values, their behaviors to you. They're setting an example for you. They're going to be the ones that give you your morals for church. They're going to be the ones that still, you know, Republican and Democrat for the most part. You know, they're going to hand out a lot of things to you. I think, you know, a big thing to keep in mind is, you know, violence is, you know, a lot of times a way a person expresses something. And if your parents don't teach you the proper ways to express feelings or don't allow you to, set a lot of bad examples there.
What do you think about when people like Jack Thompson and Dr. Phil come out to blame an incident like the Virginia Tech shootings on violent video games? In this case, specifically Counter-Strike, they did this before a suspect was even named.
I've seen Dr. Phil before. I've never seen Jack Thompson. Not firsthand knowing what they exactly did, but I think a lot of the reactions to that incident, people used it as a way to pony up a personal crusade and hop on a soapbox and try and bring a point home, whether it were, you know, tighter laws on gun control or video game violence or security on campus, police reactions to things. A lot of people use any incident like that as a way to get on their own little personal crusade and do something, instead of, you know, looking at the situation as, you know, there's a lot of people dead. We should be warning these people and examining the situation and figuring out what happened, not jumping to conclusions and making knee-jerk reactions, whether that be blaming the wrong people, laws. See, Luke? It's just a lot of those situations are used inappropriately for media coverage, for popularity, as opposed to using them for, you know, supporting victims' families. It's unfortunate that they're using that to promote their shows.
The Virginia Tech massacre and Columbine shootings were horrible events. Video games played a major role for the blame. Video games have also been the prime suspect in murder cases as well. In early 2003, a gamer known by MP5 Knight was arrested for the murder of a teenage girl. Further investigation showed that he had a lot of pictures on his computer that had to do with blood and hatred. A game he played in his spare time, Counter-Strike, was also blamed for his ways. and met up with a gamer known by Explicit who has played with MP5 Knight both online and has met him in real life.
MP5 Knight, also Sean Brown, that's his real name. He did play Counter-Strike and met him once outside of games and talked to him online. I always checked his profile, and there's always things on there about death and quotes from really dark music. And, I mean, I just think it's, you know, how somebody's brought up. People were saying in news articles that he was kind of a weirdo, an outcast at school. Only had, like, one really close friend was the other guy that he murdered that girl with. And, you know, people are just using computer gaming as a scapegoat for what he did. And, you know, people have to learn the difference from right and wrong while they're young. And obviously, you know, that never happened with him. He'll sit there and confuse reality with computer games. And people need to stop using that as a scapegoat and look at the real reason as to why people do something like that.
You could link it to anything. Make a crusade out of it, and a lot of people have. Look at Columbine, look at TV. This kind of stuff happened before there were video games and before there were TV. So, you know, what did they blame it on then? Witchcraft?
Where do we draw the line? It was a flight simulator, after all, that taught the terrorists how to fly a plane into a building that they've never even set foot in before. Do we ban those too? If a killer watched Die Hard, can we blame Bruce Willis? What other factors is Jack Thompson missing when it comes to violence in today's youth? Is it the parents? Is it the economic status? Or is it just simply knowing what's right from what's wrong? Why do we blame one specific thing before even knowing all of the facts?
And I would turn on the TV, but it's so embarrassing to see all the other people. I don't know what they mean. And it was magic at first when they spoke without sound. But now this world is gonna hurt. You better turn that thing down. Turn it around. Well, it wasn't me, says the boy with the gun. Sure, I pulled the trigger, but it needed to be done, because life's been killing me ever since it begun. You can't blame me, 'cause I'm too young. The killer was my son, but I didn't teach him to pull the trigger of the gun. It's the killing on his TV screen. You can't blame me, it's those images he sees. Well, you can't blame me, says the media man. Well, I wasn't the one who came up with the plan. And I just pulled my camera, what the people wanna see. Man, it's a two-way mirror, and you can't blame me. Of the song or the maker of the movie which he bases life on. It's only entertainment, and as anyone can see, the smoke machine's a maker, man, you can't fool me. It was you, it was me, it was every man. We've all got the blood on our hands. We only receive what we demand. And if we want hell, turn on the TV, but it's so embarrassing to see all the other people don't even know what they mean. And it was magic at first, but let everyone down. And now this world is gonna hurt.